Haptoglobin is a specific protein that binds to the free hemoglobin in the bloodstream. Also, haptoglobin considered as an acute phase reactant. With binding to hemoglobin, haptoglobin form hemoglobin-haptoglobin complex, which is very rapidly cleared by macrophages in the spleen. Because of this specific function, any increase in free hemoglobin level in the blood will cause decrease in the level of haptoglobin. And the most common condition that causes increase in free hemoglobin level is hemolytic anemia. So, decrease in haptoglobin level is a marker of hemolytic anemia. So let's explain the relation between hemolytic anemia and haptoglobin. Liver produces a specific protein called haptoglobin. Haptoglobin enters into the bloodstream, and the normal concentration of haptoglobin in the bloodstream is 0.3 to 2.0 grams per liter, or 30 to 200 milligrams per deciliter. In the blood we have red blood cells. Red blood cells inside them have hemoglobin. In normal condition, red blood cells and haptoglobin do not interact with each other. They circulate through the bloodstream separately. But sometimes, some pathogenic factors can cause severe damage to red blood cells. Or in case of splenomegaly, hypersplenism can develop when macrophages in the spleen become overreactive and they begin to overconsume red blood cells by phagocytosis. Both these conditions cause destruction of red blood cells, and destruction of red blood cells we call hemolysis. With destruction of red blood cells, hemoglobin becomes free. And free hemoglobin in the bloodstream is a very dangerous substance. Recall that hemoglobin consists of heme and globin, and heme is iron in complex with protoporphyrin. Free iron is an extremely dangerous substance. First of all, free iron can trigger Fenton reaction with production of massive amount of reactive oxygen species. This can cause severe damage to tissues. Also, free iron is essential molecule for the bacteria growth, because bacteria cannot live without iron. So, excessive amount of free iron in the bloodstream can greatly increase the risk of infection. That's why we consider haptoglobin an acute phase reactant. So, to prevent these dangerous consequences of hemolysis, we have haptoglobin. Once free hemoglobin is released, haptoglobin binds to hemoglobin with formation of hemoglobin-haptoglobin complex, and in this binded form, hemoglobin becomes a safe substance. Then hemoglobin-haptoglobin complex undergo phagocytosis by splenic macrophages, and by this we remove free hemoglobin and haptoglobin from the blood. Because spleen remove from the blood not only free hemoglobin but also haptoglobin, the level of haptoglobin in the blood decreases. So decrease in haptoglobin is provoked by a release of free hemoglobin, and the release of free hemoglobin is caused by hemolysis of red blood cells. So that's why decrease in haptoglobin is a marker of hemolytic anemia.